Hello, welcome to Little Smiles International School Basic 6 online tutorial. Our subject for today is our world and our people, and it is taken from strand 1, all about us. Substrand 2, myself. Indicator 2, personal hygiene. When we say personal hygiene, what is your understanding about personal hygiene? Let's look at the meaning of personal hygiene. Personal hygiene means maintaining cleanliness of one's body and clothing to preserve overall health and well-being. Let's take it again. Personal hygiene means maintaining cleanliness of one's body and clothing to preserve overall health and well-being. So anything that you do to maintain good health of your body is termed as personal hygiene. Below are some steps to take to observe personal hygiene. We are going to look at some steps to take to observe personal hygiene. One, bathing. We have to bath twice in a day, that is morning and evening. We have to bath in the morning and in the evening. Two, brush your teeth every morning and evening. You have to brush your teeth in the morning and in the evening when you are going to bed. Three, use deodorant. This will prevent body odor. So the use of deodorant will prevent body odor from the armpit and other parts. Four, wash your clothes after wearing them. You don't have to wear clothes continuously for more than 2 days. You have to wash it because dirty clothes may make you smell. Five, trim your hair every 4 to 8 weeks. You have to trim your hair nicely every 4 to 8 weeks. Six, clip your fingernails and toenails regularly. So anytime you see that your fingernails are growing very long or too long, you have to clip it. And your toenails. Seven, wash your hands with soap and running water after visiting the toilet. You have to wash your hands well. Thoroughly wash your hands with soap and running water after visiting the washroom or the toilet. Eight, cover your nose and mouth when you cough or sneeze. You don't have to cough or sneeze into the open air. You have to cover your nose with either your bent elbow or tissue paper. Nine, don't share razors, towels, or makeup with other people. You don't have to share personal belongings with other people, as it may cause transfer of diseases to different people. Number 10, if you are a woman, change your pad regularly, as it may cause toxic shock syndrome. So if you're a woman or you're a teenager and you've menstruated, you have to change your pad regularly. Anytime you feel that it is too wet, you have to change it because it can cause a disease we call toxic shock syndrome. Children, below this tutorial, there are works under it. Download and answer them and present them at the school premises for marking. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. And we'll meet again in our next tutorial. Until then, bye-bye.